You don't know me.
Confession I can't take back.
I am...
The Masked Speaker.
Have you ever promised to take something to your grave?
Ooh.
Ooh.
Well, you should come here, because this show is like a graveyard for promising careers.
Isn't that true?
Oh my God, why are you looking at me?
I'm speaking to the souls of the people on this show. But no, we'll let you get things off your chest with this segment called The Masked Speaker.
Yes.
And one of our listeners is on the phone, ready to give us their confession. She's choosing to use the fake name Blair. So hey, Blair, how you doing today?
Hi, I'm doing all right. How are you guys doing?
Oh, man. Better now that you're on the phone.
Yeah.
I'm intrigued, Blair.
So, Blair, you are today's mass speaker. We've altered your voice using our voice changer, so no one will know who you are. Whenever you're ready, go ahead. Tell us your big confession.
So, my mother currently lives in a retirement home. She's lived there for a couple of years now.
Okay.
Her and my dad were married for about 42 years, but they've always lived separately, like, my entire life.
Oh.
She's always lived at a different house down the street.
Okay, so they were like, they were divorced or they just...
They were married, yeah. They were married, they just lived separately.
Huh. Okay.
You don't hear about that a lot. That's pretty rare.
Yeah, they were happy. They just had their reasons for living apart, and that's, I think, what made their relationship really work.
That's probably why they were happy.
Yeah.
They didn't live together.
Yeah.
I'm sure there's a lot of married couples listening right now that are like,
wait
that's
a minute.
Great idea.
Not a bad idea. Yeah.
Put her somewhere else.
Because right now I hate you.
Yeah.
Sorry, Blair. So go ahead. You're saying they were married for 42 years?
So they've been married 42 years, but recently my father passed away.
Oh, I'm sorry. No. That's so hard.
We're just joking. My bad.
Thank you. I appreciate it. It's okay. Honestly, it was his time.
Yeah.
That's
yeah. It's still so hard for you, mm-hmm. you know?
It is. It really is, because it really, you know, messed up, like, the dynamic that we had as a family.
Mm-hmm.
But here's where my secret more so comes in.
Okay.
So the thing is, since they didn't live together, my mom didn't know that my dad passed away. And I was the only one who knew, and I was supposed to tell her.
Oh, wait, what?
Yeah, she just didn't know. And it's just, I don't want her to find out.
Why?
Wait a minute. Whoa. Why would you not tell your mom that her husband passed away? And why wouldn't she be there when it happened? Yeah. Like, that's so important.
So, honestly, when someone dies out of a long-term relationship, usually the other person in that couple passes away shortly after.
Yeah.
And I don't want to lose my mom. I don't want to tell her what happened and then lose my mom.
Oh, my God.
My God.
I mean, how does she not know about this if this happened months ago?
Well, one of the things that I do to make sure she doesn't find out is I dress up as my dad and I visit her once or twice a week and just pretend to be him.
Whoa.
Wait.
Hold on.
She falls for that?
Is your mom blind?
What do you mean? Yeah, exactly. She have terrible vision? She got cataracts that were never fixed? Like, what's going on? How?
I guess I'm just lucky because I already look a lot like my dad. And I'll just wear one of his sweaters, put on one of his old hats, glasses, and I'll just, like, move slowly and imitate his voice. And she loves it.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
You almost deserve an award for how good that is.
Dude, that's, like, diabolical. This is, like, I don't know, man.
It must be weird when you guys are, like, you know, having that special time.
Hopefully it never gets to that point.
It definitely doesn't.
Yeah, I know. I'm kidding. Sorry.
You know, I know it sounds weird to other people, but it's what keeps her going. And I don't want to lose her. I just want her to be happy. So for me to do that, it's really for her.
Oh, I see why.
Has there ever been, like, a close call where she almost called you out or you messed something up? Because I would assume that she would talk about really intimate things. How do you pull that off?
I think the good thing about pretending to be an old person is you could just be like, huh?
Yeah.
I don't remember. And that's literally pretty believable.
Yeah.
Actually, that does help a lot.
Really?
Okay.
Good. Be very vague.
What if she finds out?
I don't think she'll find out. Luckily, my father was a man of few words, so just sitting and nodding is really doing most of the work already.
Wow.
When we go out to lunch on Sundays, I get my dad's favorite meal.
Wait, you do this in public?
Yeah, I kind of keep it going. I mean, I can't be like, oh, we can't go out anymore all of a sudden. Like, you know, she is in a nursing home. She does have issues with her memory.
Yeah.
So Sometimes we just sit in silence holding hands, and so I'm going to keep doing this.
You better pray one day she's not like, we should go to lunch with our daughter.
Yeah.
It'd be nice to have all of us together.
Yeah. Huh? Who?
Yeah, we don't have a daughter.
Yeah. Could they like hang out without you?
Well, so does the staff at the retirement home realize that you're doing this?
No, they just think I'm a regular visitor.
Oh,
they really don't know.
So, I wouldn't question an old person if they looked old. They're like, be like, hey, wait a minute, you know?
Yeah. She's going through all the steps, too. She's ordering, you know, the French onion soup.
Yeah, at 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
It's very believable.
Wow. With extra
That's
fruit.
Commitment. Yeah.
Please call us if you ever get outed. I want to hear what happens, okay?
I hope I never do, but if I do, I will let you know. But let's hope it doesn't happen.
Okay.
All right.
I don't know if she has any siblings, but I'm just picturing like her sibling is dressing up as her mom and she's dressing up as her dad. And they're both trying to convince each other that they're still around.
It's like a twisted Lindsay Lohan movie.
Yeah, it's a little Freaky Friday action for you.
The new cats dress like the old dog.
Yeah. It's a weird family, but thank you so much for sharing that with us, Blair.
Thanks for letting me.
Text into 78592. Too. If you have a confession you've been holding on to, we can hide your identity by masking your voice so you can become the next mass speaker. We've got your phone tap coming up next.